put on the table, what do we think network edge is?
So in my mind, what network edge is really, it's really about the software and the applications that are being deployed all over the place.
Yeah.
So it's really an outgrowth of, again, that cloud, that cloud compute application layer, where we have these other technologies where you need the software spread around, right? And it's primarily driven by latency, right? The classic case would be that we talk about a lot is an autonomous car. So if you're driving, if your car is driving you around, you may need to pick up a data center as it moves along to do some compute on the sensors and the technology that are going on inside the car.
Sure.
So there isn't enough time for that information to go back to a cloud data center that it needs to be on a more a faster response time. So that's really what's driving it. It's really about the software. The 5G piece of it is just the communication that's enabling it to happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that is the next generation communication that will drive that, right? But it's not exactly the thing that really, in my mind, what it's about. It's really about the technology that's being deployed in all these new types of situations and the fast response time that's required to really make that work.
Our customers are seeing that instead of being in a purpose-built data center facility, now they're having to put compute at a legacy infrastructure type site, like a switching station or a factory. So what challenges does that present to the customer now where they're moving outside of the data center?
Well, really, a lot of it is about the physical location that you need to put the data center, right?
Yeah.
So you're going to be dispersed around a geography, around a city.
Yeah.
You're going to have a smaller data center, right? So isn't it going to be a hyperscale data center that you're going to need to deploy? And they got to figure out what the right places are and then find the right locations, right? So a lot of times we see clients looking at cell towers, for example, or looking for locations along highways where there is land available so that they can place these things in the right place.
Yeah.
But it's really an interesting thing that's going to be growing as more and more of these applications come up. And as you said, everything gets smarter and smarter. That's what we're going to need to do.
Yeah. 10 years ago or 15 years ago, it used to be, you know, our attention span was about 7 seconds. If a website wasn't loading in 7 seconds, you would switch to the next one. And now I want to say it's sub 1 second, right? Like click doesn't work. Oh, you go to the next thing. So the same thing on a much more granular scale is happening with data and the ability for, you know, a machine. If you think about a machine that's clicking off 1,000 widgets, you know, in a minute, for sampling and quality purposes, it's doing sub-cycle sampling. So the compute has to be right there. It can't go all the way back to the cloud and come back. So the last part that I had said earlier was, what's the connection between edge and cloud?
I mean, the way I think about it, edge is really just an extension of cloud, right? Mm-hmm. Edge is, you know, more and more what's going to enable cloud to continue to grow, right? So a lot of people believe edge is going to be even greater growth in the cloud in the future because of all of these new applications. Because we're making everything smart, you're going to need much more compute on the edge. But they're definitely tethered together. In a lot of ways, an edge data center is really just a waypoint to the cloud, right?
Yeah.
So it's a very tight ecosystem, and they rely on each other for sure.
So for our watchers, let's give a cool use. What's something that's innovative that people maybe wouldn't think that would be something that would be kind of this edge-driven technology that's we've seen or have talked to customers about?
You know, we have a few clients. There's one really cool thing where, you know, and a lot of we can relate to in retail space, right? You know, where you can get home deliveries via a drone, right? If we've seen pictures of a drone dropping off your delivery in your backyard, you know, those are very cool use cases.
Right.
But all of that is enabled by an edge data center somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Because again, it's going to have some sensors. It's going to have some understanding of the area for that to work. So that's an example of something that I think it's coming, right?
Yeah.
And it's going to be coming more and more, and maybe it'll be a little different than that in the future. But if you think about something like that as a drone moves around a city, it's going to have a sensor network and things like that.
Sure.